Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to show you some of my makeup products that I have. Some of these I probably won't keep after going through them because I haven't actually done this for a very long time. And as I'm doing this, I will be writing down products that I need to restock and update, such as my bronzers and highlighters, because my highlighter stash is pretty awful. So if you like this video, give it a big thumbs up and stay tuned. Okay guys, I have organized my makeup into sections, and then I will go through some of the products with you. A lot of these are very well loved, as you can tell. They're a bit dirty. So here I have my mascaras, my eyeliners. Here are my bronzers and highlighters. They're my powders, my blush, my brow products, and my eyeshadow palettes and individual pressed shadows. And then here I have my loose powders, so my dusts. This little product here is by Smolder. It's a little cream, and you pop it on your eye first and then you pop these over the top, and what it does is it just intensifies the color. I'll show you later. I've got my lip liners and eyeliners. Not that I think they're all lip liners, actually. Oh no, there's a couple of brow liners in there. Then I've got my massive stash of lipsticks, my foundations, the ones that my husband didn't chuck out on me. That's a long story. my primer and my moisturizer serum, my glow, it's like a shimmery illuminator, and then back here is my concealer palette and my contour, but it's a cream. So yeah. So to start off cool. with, I'm gonna pop all these in my drawer. It's just a little slidey out there. Just try and organize them, so bear with me. To start off with though, I've got this little lipstick holder. Pop that in. So I really love like NYX Liquid Suede lipsticks. This is a very, very bright colour. But ignore my cat. Also, hey Simon. He's crazy. So I do have a lot of NYX liquid cream lipsticks in here. I'm not a fan of like the butter glosses and all really dark like brown colours. I love bright pinks. I like this colour, but I don't like the texture of it on my lips. I'm getting a little bit into the purples, but no. So these two lipsticks here, I actually have a red one that I am in love with, but I don't know where it's gone. These lipsticks are amazing. They're by Clara Cosmetics. They are a cream lipstick. They're matte and
they're called Kiss Proof Lips.
I've had these for a while now. They're my absolute favourites. Never getting rid of them. I don't necessarily wear this colour very much, but I do clients' makeup all the time, so you never know what they like. This one here is another favourite of mine. All the stickers have come off
so I can't even tell you what shade it is. But it is a ColourPop cream lipstick, and it is again one of my favourite colours. You can see that colour, pinky colour there. I wore that in one of my tutorials. It's fantastic, actually. I love it. So it lasts really long too. Like, I love the wear out of it. So then I have my Kylie Jenner lipsticks. They're basically the same as these ones. They're cream lipsticks. As you can tell, they are my favourites. These colours I don't really wear. They look, they're old, obviously, but I don't wear them very much. These ones I got for Christmas, so I haven't really worn them very much yet. These are the birthday collection, I'm pretty sure. They're pretty. I've swatched them. I probably don't go to these colours very much. So the purples and the mauvey colours I don't really wear. There's this, these are the Coco collection. These one I haven't worn. I think I've worn these two, and I use them on clients a lot. This one I'm a bit unsure about. But yeah, I keep all of these because I have a lot of people that like them, so. So then we have my NYX liquid suede, the larger ones. This colour here I used for a makeup look that I did. I'll pop it in the next slide. I'll show you what makeup look I did, and I used that lip. This one I absolutely love, it's so bright and fun. These two I don't really wear. I think they're new too, actually. I think I got them for Christmas, but I haven't worn them. I probably won't go towards them, but you never know, someone might like them. Okay, so the last ones we have is my NYX mini, like my small ones. You've got your lingerie. I don't even know what ones they are. They're lip creams, but they're like a crayon. We've got butter gloss, we've got the liquid suede, lip cream. So these orangey colors, like, I love bright colors, but I don't really wear them. Maybe I might be brave. I love this color, but I don't think I like the consistent. Yeah, it's a butter gloss. I don't really like the glossy looks. I love matte colors. This one's cool, but I haven't found the right look to wear with it yet. This Revlon one here, I've never ever worn. I bought it when I was going through my red stage, but I hated it, so never worn it. This is my nude. I love this nude. It's my go-to nude shade. It is a couldn't even tell you what. And I think it was like Maybelline. I'm not sure. Couldn't tell you. Sorry. So there are my lipsticks. Pretty cool. Slowly growing. Up here is my we call them lip liners. I've got a white eyeliner. I think there's a brown eyeliner in there too. My nudes. I don't really go for pencil liners, so I don't have many of them. And I actually don't wear a lot of lip liners unless I'm doing clients. So, yeah. So I think next we'll go on to my shadows. So here are my palettes. I really need to go in and clean them because they're a bit dirty. But they're well loved, very well used. So these ones here, not that one. These ones here I got for Christmas, so I haven't tried them. I'm pretty keen to try them. I like these colours here. I love this blue. I actually love that colour. I swatched that one. It was amazing. I'll show you. So this is it here. It's like a navy blue shimmery colour, and that's what it swatches like. You can't really tell. It just looks really black there. But you can see there the pigment of it. So I think you just have to pack it on pretty much. My Kylie palettes. Oh dear. So dirty.
This Is Well Loved. I've only had it since my birthday in July. It's now January, so you can tell that these colours get used a lot. I go for these four colours here. I don't really go down to these ones very often. A little bit, but not much. Then we've got my purple palette. This is actually a ripoff, so you'll probably look at this and go, hang on, they're not the same colours. They're not. Some of them are the same, but it cost me $3, so I bought it. And it still has great pigment in it. I used this when I went to a wedding. I actually used this for my purple look. If you go and look on my purple shadow look, I used this one. And then this one is another ripoff, but they didn't use their Kylie Jenner logo. It's by Flossie. And it's basically the same as Kylie's burgundy palette, I think. But yeah, these ones are pretty cool. I used these ones for my pink look here. I don't really use golds. Sometimes I use like more bronzy colours. This little product here is like a cream shadow. Now I actually used to use this for my like shadow base before I got my, oh goodness, Simon, get out. So I used to use this for my shadow base before I got into concealer, so it's pretty old. Don't really use it that much anymore, so still a good little handy shadow palette. If I can open it, yes. Look at these are amazing. I love these colours, this colour especially. Check that out. So when I do like a bronze smoky eye, I tend to use this palette. This one's pretty cool too. It's like a black, but it, let's see if I can swatch it. It has like gold reflectance in it, so it's cool. It's not my favourite colour. These ones here are okay. They don't have a lot of pigment in them. These ones are alright, these three. But I love these, this shimmer and these two shimmers right here. So it's by You Can Be. I actually haven't even tried to say this brand before, but I got it off AliExpress and it also cost me like $2. So these two palettes here were actually my very first two eyeshadow palettes that I had. I really loved these. I used to use this for my black bronzy smoky eye look before I got my other palettes. And these ones I used to use like purple, but you can see that it's not worn in so far, but I didn't really use shadows a lot back in the day. I was the eyeliner, mascara, foundation. That was it. That was my look. So I did my apprenticeship in beauty therapy and I expanded. So this is Australis Intensify Wet Dry Shadows. They got a bit of colour in them. This one is your Maybelline. This palette here I've actually lost the lid to. And I know the name of it, but I can't think of it right now. But these are just really like good shimmery colours. I use this one for a really nice navy smoky eyed look. I'll insert that right now. But yeah, these, I just really love these colours. I go back to these pretty often. I really like them. Close to home. These are my nude palettes by Maybelline. These are the blushed nudes and these are just nudes. I don't really use these on myself very much, but I do use them on clients, especially if clients want like that more natural pinky toned soft look, I'll use them. But yeah, I don't really use these on myself much, but I will be keeping them because I use them on my clients a lot. So yeah, they're pretty good. They're a bit dirty. Again, I'm really sorry for the condition that my makeup is in. I need to go through after this and wipe them all down. But yeah. This palette here is actually basically brand new. I got this, I did drop it. I was pretty sad when I dropped it. Very sad actually. But I got this palette from Bella Box. I will actually, when I get my next one, I'll be doing a unboxing video. But it's by Style London. Yeah, these are really cute. They're like golds, like browns, you got your pinky tones, you got your matte with your shimmers. These are nice blue tones. That was a nice goldy shimmery color. So then we have my loose dusts. So this one I got off AliExpress for like a dollar, just for a look that I wanted to create. It's like a pinky goldy color. This is mauve, but I don't think it's mauve tone. Pearl. Yeah. These ones, oh, I didn't even realize I put a foundation in these, but these are really old too. These were back in the day. So they're just loose powders, Sunlight, Mystique, and Midnight. So this is like a really dark shade. This is like the purpley, and this is just a nice, like, I don't know, neutral tone, skin color tone. They're really cute actually. They're very messy to use, but Cosmetics, this one's very messy, but I'll open it and I'll show you, because oh dear, trying to open with one hand is ridiculous. So sorry. I'm pretty sure this wasn't loose. I'm pretty sure it was pressed, but when I bought it, it was like this, so I just go with it. But it's like a really nice pinky, purpley, shimmery colour. It's really great. I like it. Now we're going to move on to my favourite brand, Smolder Cosmetics. Flippin' love this brand. It's so amazing. I'm about to show you some colours. But this one is pink gold. I used this in a little video that I did. This one, what's this color again? Burnt copper. This one's just bronze igloo. Cranberry sample. This one's just a little sample, but it's really cute. And like I showed you guys before, the dazzle lock, which helps to intensify the color. So I'm going to show you some. Okay guys, so the top color is the one with the dazzle lock, and the bottom one is just swatched normally. So you can tell that the top one, it with the dazzle lock, it really does just bring out that color just that little bit more. Yeah, it's a great product, and it helps it to stick better too. So yeah, I love it. Give it a try, Smolder Cosmetics. Okay, onto my brow products. So these three are Piney Cosmetics. You've probably seen me use these. So they're called Mainstain. These four are my little godsend. These are from my work. So I work at Bracture in Dubbo. Google it, Facebook it, Instagram it, do brows. I'm a great brow artist and lash extension artist. But so they're pomades, and they're like the brow gel. They are waterproof and really easy to use. They don't come off, they're well loved. I've got every color, well, almost every color, and I use them daily and on my clients. I can get away with blonde or brown with them. They're well loved. So I've got the brow shaping kit by Astralis, which it's basically never been touched. I think I tried the gel once, didn't like it. The waxy gel, didn't like it. And I don't go for powders for brows. I really like the pomade, the cream textures. they're just so much better. So yeah. Then we have this like tinted brow gel that my boss gave me. It's okay. Not a great fan of it. I got this out of Bella Box as well, but I don't really use pencils, so not a great fan. And then we've got the Pony Cosmetics Zebra Brow Gel. I don't really like this brow gel. I don't think it holds very well. Yeah, we've got one at work and it's my absolute favourite, so I don't really go for this very often. Okay, so now we've got our highlighters, bronzers, and blushes. So this was my very first blush highlight contour duo by Napoleon. It's very old, as you can see, there's no lid on it. I used to use this pretty often. I used to use the blush a little bit, but I don't go much on the Napoleon blush. I think it's, when I use blush, I use this one. But I don't really like that full rosy pink color. This one is a cream blush. I'm not gonna open it because I'm pretty sure it's pretty dirty inside. But I don't use that very often. We have Astralis Show Me Some Cheek Blush. Don't really use that either. I don't really use blush anymore. I like that bronzed look. But if I find a nice blush, I'll probably use it. So yeah, you've got your Mosaic Tile blush. So you can tell that I use that one more than the other one. Hit the pan. So then we've got my Astralis bronzing powder and highlight powders. This one's in a pink color. This one's like more an orangey color. I got this one for my birthday, but I don't really like, I think it's pretty chalky on me. I don't think it does much. I actually don't think that Astralis highlighter has a lot of color to it, but I do use it when I want to. Now that I've got this little beauty, so a highlighter liquid, so I pop that on and then I pop that over the top and it gives it a bit more colour and shine to it. And my bronzing powder, I don't really use this one very much. When I do use, I kind of use this one a lot more. Hit the pan. Napoleon set bronzing powder. Yeah, I really like this one, but I do want to try and use this one a little bit more, but I just don't really go for it. So I have this one too. It's by Clara Cosmetics. I don't really use that very much. It's actually got a nice tone. I might use it when I get a tan. See how it goes. It's pretty natural when you pop it on your face, like it doesn't do too much, but yeah. I got this little one out of Bella Box as well, e.l.f. Sun-Kissed Glow Bronzer. I don't really think it does that much, so I'm not a fan of it. I used it once, but yeah, not a great fan. Probably don't use it ever again. Go to someone. I haven't used it. It's a bronzing and highlighting shimmer highlight duo, bronze gold. So I should probably try it. It's like a creamy consistency. So yeah, I should try that one actually. It's the 3can Take Me on Tour Contour and Highlighting Kit by Astralis. Yeah, you can see that doesn't have any colour to it, and this one's only got a little bit, like it's not fantastic. I don't know if you can see that, but it's very chalky, no shimmer in it at all. Not a fan. Love. Thanks Napoleon, I love this. Mascaras and my eyeliners. This one's pretty cool, I need a look to try it. So it's a liquid liner in Napoleon. It's got blue liquid liner and then it's got like this blue shimmery glitter gel to go over the top. I haven't had a look to try, but I will try that soon. So Maybelline Master Precise liquid liner is my favorite, well, was my favorite liquid liner until I discovered this one by Maybelline as well. But this one here
has just a really fine tip to it. This one actually, depending on the way that you hold it, changes the thickness. So it's got a thin part and a thick part on it. I don't know if you'll be able to see. So that's the thick. So if you apply it like that, it'll be nice and thick. If you apply it like that, it's nice and thin. So yeah, it's really cool. So then we've got my mascaras. So Rimmel Scandalize Extreme. This is a really good one for volume. My Panic Cosmetics White Night Mascara, which I reviewed for you guys the other day. I love this one. It's really good. It's for length and volume. We have the Zoo Organic. It's really good too. I really like this because it is organic, so I know that it's not going to do too much damage to my lashes, but it doesn't do much to your lashes. So it doesn't create a lot of thickness or length to it. More for just darkness, but it is a nice product. I got it out of Bella.
This needs to be chalked actually.
3D Lash. It was great when I was using it, but it's really old and it doesn't work anymore. So bye bye 3D Lash. So my powders, I need to update them because they're pretty old. So I've got these crop powders. They are, I'm pretty sure they're like mineral makeup. Don't really use them unless I have a client that wants mineral makeup. These are pressed. This one's like a loose powder. I have used this one a few times. It's nice. Light to medium, but I do prefer, as you can tell, my Astralis Fresh Flawless Pressed Powder. So I use the color Natural. I think they're both natural. Yeah. They're old, very old. They're empty, basically. I need new ones. So I have three of them and they're all empty. They're great. I really like them. They help my makeup to stick very well. Then we've got, these are actually foundations, but they're like a cream pressed. I'm not a fan of these two at all, actually. I don't like the consistency, but I keep them there just in case. My concealer. So I've got Revlon Colorstay in light and medium. So I actually like these. They're pretty good. They have a pretty good coverage. Pretty affordable. I think I got them from Target. But yeah, they're really good. I like them. I use the light a lot more than the medium because that's basically my skin colour. So I need the light one to break up
my colour. Astralis Contour Contouring Highlighting.
You can see they're very well loved, but this is what I used to use before I got these ones. So these are very like oily consistency. Now I basically just use this one to like sculpt my face, and my Revlon to do anything else. I don't really touch any of them anymore, so sorry. Foundation, dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. And my primer and my illuminator and my moisturizer serum. Okay, so this one's basically empty. It's got a little bit left. This is my Napoleon Purtis Advanced Mineral Makeup in Look 3 Medium. This is like my tanned colour. And I have no tan, I'm like look 2 palers. So yeah, I really like this. But $70 for this, and I use it in less than 3 months. So I don't really go for. If I've got special events or something on, I'll wear this one. But for my all day, every day, I'll use Astralis, the O2Glow, or these ones. They're not in my colour. They are nude. But they're like, okay, these are my light colour. So, I had this one in the Natural Form, but I used all that. and it's been thrown out. But I also had another one that I really liked. It was, I think it was L'Oreal. And it was really nice too. I got that off my boss because she moved since she left it. So she gave it to me and I really like it. Kat Von D I really like too. It's a really full coverage makeup. It's just a shade too light for my skin. But it's really good. This one is a nice dark colour for my darker clients that I use. So obviously I don't use that on myself. Same with the Revlon Colourstay, it's darker than my skin tone, so that's just for clients as well, but I actually need to stock up. It's non-client makeup season, so I don't have a lot of foundations, I just have what I have. But I'm also on holidays, so I'm not really wearing makeup, so I don't really have my foundation. I need to do that before I go back to work. So this is a Dermaveen Intense Moisturizing Facial Serum. So it actually comes with like a little tube on the inside that you press, and it's like a really nice hydrating serum. This is a Mena Glow Illuminator. I got this off AliExpress as well. I really like this. It gives a good glow, so I moisturize, I prime, I illuminate, and then I do my foundation. So this is an old primer too. I really want to try out some new ones this year. New year, new me. So it's really good. It goes well with my Australis foundations because it's water-based and they're water-based, so they go on well together. So yeah, I've actually finished reviewing all of my products for you guys. Again, I really hope you enjoyed going through some of these. If there's any videos that you want me to do, like showing you what they look like on my face, I can do that for you. But yeah, I really hope you enjoyed. If you have, give it a big thumbs up and subscribe, and stay tuned for some more videos. Happy 2018, guys.